So today I am in the house of Mr. Vasko Petrov. Vasko, thank you for inviting me into your home and to
Hello.
taking the time to sit down and have this short interview. Let's get right to it. You're originally from Bulgaria.
Yes, I am.
Now, how was life in Bulgaria for you?
All right. I actually was born in Bulgaria long time ago, 76 years ago, in a very little village there. I grew up there. I studied there. I graduate middle school there, and then I moved to a nearby town which is called Svistov for my high school graduation. So I went there for 4 years, actually 5 years, and I graduated high school at that nearby town, which is 20 miles away from that village. After that, I had to go to military. Every boy after high school, or if doesn't go to high school, after 11 years, they were obligated to serve in Bulgarian national military.
You don't have a choice about that.
No choice unless you're sick.
All
If
right.
you're in good health,
You're in the military.
you're in the military.
Okay.
Different type of military, kind of military, but you should go there.
Okay.
Right now, it's not anymore like that. Now our army is already paid army.
Okay.
At that time, we were not paid. You just serve for in military, and that's all.
Now, did you like life in Bulgaria?
At that time, I did like it
You did
because I
like it.
couldn't compare with anything else.
Okay.
We didn't have enough information about the other world. I mean, the West countries, Germany or capitalist countries. Bulgaria was a communist country, satellite of Soviet Union. So all we knew is what is in Bulgaria.
Now, when you began your career, you were.
Actually, before I began my career, I graduated bachelor, master, and PhD in Soviet Union in Moscow.
So you lived in Moscow.
I lived 9 years in Moscow,
Okay. And now
studying there.
did you move back to Bulgaria?
After that, I came back to Bulgaria and started working. First, I worked in Technical University of Bulgaria in Sofia, and then I moved after I completed a PhD. I moved to Bulgarian Academy of Science,
Okay.
becoming a science. And I was there until I became a senior scientist in Bulgaria. Meanwhile, while I was there in 1983, the first time I visited United States as an exchange scientist, which they accepted me as a visiting professor.
And how long did you stay in the States?
At that time, in 1983, 1984, I was here 6.5 months.
Oh, so a pretty good amount of
So,
time.
yes, I was a visiting professor, but I wasn't teaching. I was just doing my research there on crystal growth.
Okay.
So after my PhD, coming back a little bit, I graduated crystal growth in Moscow. So I'm an expert on growing crystals. We call them growing crystals, not producing, because crystals, single crystals, meaning single crystals, they grow just like plants, like
All right,
animals.
what are you doing? What's the purpose of crystals? What are they doing with them?
They do different, well, crystals have different needs. So one of the crystals are your cell phones, right there in those phones, everything is there. The other crystals are very, very, very common crystals. Those are silicon crystals. All computers all over the world are built up on chips on silicon single crystals.
Okay.
But
And they're still that way.
it's still that way.
Okay.
I used to grow optical crystals for different optical purposes also. Laser crystals for lasers, like ruby, like garnet, or other laser crystals. Those are called hard crystals. But anyway, crystals have a lot of different purposes to grow them. I was growing mainly at that time. While I was in Bulgaria, when I was here first time in the United States, I was growing laser and optical crystals.
Okay. Now, Why would you want to leave Bulgaria? It seems like you had a pretty good life, you had a good career. Why leave Bulgaria?
I actually didn't want to leave Bulgaria.
You did not want
to leave. I didn't plan to leave Bulgaria. But okay. While I was here, first time in the United States, as a research professor, with my advisor, supervisor, Professor Wilcox, who was also chairman of the chemistry department, we published a couple of three different publications on crystal growth. And one of the owners of the small company, Crystal Growth Company, his name is Michael Urbanik, he offered me a job here in the United States. I immediately called back to my professor Wilcox and asked him, what do you think? He said, that's a good idea. Why don't you come here and have some experience in the United States?
So your initial thought was to be here for maybe like a short amount of time?
Only years. My visa was for only 2 years.
And you were fine with that?
And I agreed with that. I was happy. Bulgaria was still a communist country at that time. My salary in Bulgaria was pretty low, although it was very high for Bulgaria, like a senior scientist, but pretty low compared with the United States. But I came here, I thought, I'll come to the United States, I'll make a lot of money for 2 years, I'll come back to Bulgaria and I live as a king.
Okay,
with this money here. But it didn't work this way. Americans know how to take your money out of you. I came here, I got a high salary, but I had to pay much higher than I used to pay in Bulgaria. Car insurance, health insurance, village housing. Yeah. And I was paying $650 for one bedroom apartment. So by the end of these 2 years, I only had saved $3,000.
So why not go back to Bulgaria and stay there?
And when I figured this out, but meanwhile, Bulgaria became a democratic capitalist country. Mm. So no more communism there. And that also destroyed Bulgarian economy totally. So there was no need to go back to Bulgaria because...
Well, you still had, but you still had a life there. You still had your family there, friends.
After the first year I was here, I invited my wife here and my son.
So they came here.
They came here. So, and after the first year, after I figured out I'm not going to make enough money to go back and live on that salary, I tried to get my permanent residency. And I applied for permanent residency. And because I was here at work and I had my, it was called H-1 visa, working visa, I applied for my family, for my son, for my wife, for her sons also. So we all got, in the first 2 years before I left here, we got permanent residence, so-called green card. Mm-hmm. It is not green at all. It is pink. but I don't know why they call it green card.
Yeah, that is, I always thought it would be a green card. It's not.
It's not. Huh. Maybe sometimes years ago it was green. But
or maybe the same
when
green
I got it,
the American money.
Maybe.
Who knows?
But when I got it, it was pink, and I was very much surprised.
That's actually interesting.
So we all got a permanent residency here, and that's how I left here. I decided that I can stay as long as I can here. However, I never planned, I'm still not planning to die here. I'm still thinking that one day I'll go back.
All right, we'll get to that. Now, when you're here, in those early days, how was it settling? How was it fitting in? How was it for your family, like becoming acclimated to a new country? How does that work? Like, how's your English speaking skills, your sons, your wife?
All right, that was different for me and for my family. I actually completed an English course in Bulgaria, 6 months English course. So I was capable to speak a little bit English.
Okay.
To understand a little bit and to speak. However, I still don't know very well English. My kids, they knew a little bit English in Bulgaria because the internet came in, all this stuff, and there is movies, all this stuff. At my time, I didn't have that chance. So they had a little bit English. My wife was just like me. So they started here, kids went to the school, and a year later they were speaking like American. Because in the school they speak, they write, they listen, and they study all in English. So very quickly they became, you won't hear them, any accent of them. They don't accent, they speak like American. I have my accent, it will stay all with me. My wife has her accent, it will stay. I came here 50 years old, so I can't change my accent anymore. Now, it wasn't difficult. Actually, my colleagues at work helped me a lot with English.
Now, where were you working at? Now you're on your visa. Where were you employed? What were you doing?
Employed in the small crystal growth company called Commercial Crystal Growth.
And where was this located?
That was located in Naples, Florida.
So you were down in Florida, okay.
I was down in Florida for 2 years. Okay. After 2 years, let me start with that. The salary they offered me here was twice smaller than any American citizen living here, studying here, graduating here, had here. But I accepted that because I thought one day I'll grow up. And that was the advice of my professor, who I was visiting there before. It didn't work this way. Mm-hmm. 2 years later, I asked my boss, the owner, single owner, Michael Urbanik, I asked him to raise my salary. I have two kids in the school. The older one was already in the college, and I need to pay his tuition. My wife was here, didn't have any job. He rejected me, didn't give me. I started looking for a job somewhere. The first person I sent my resume turned to be a friend of my boss. And call him, hey, Mikey, you know your guy there, that Bulgarian, wants to work with me. Next morning I went to work. My stuff was out in front of the door, and my boss said, if you come in the store, in the company, I'll call the police.
So you were fired?
I was fired. At that time, I have no idea he didn't have any right to fire me because I'm looking for a job. Even if I had that idea, later on I learned, that wouldn't help me because he would anytime say, okay, I didn't fire him, I just laid him off because we don't need his business anymore. So it wouldn't help me. So I was fired. And I found a job on the other side of Florida, on the west, or the east side. A gentleman there wanted to start his own crystal growth company. But he didn't have much idea. I went there, started working there, worked 1 year there, but it didn't work because he didn't have enough money and he couldn't get enough loans to start over the new company. While I was there, I started looking for a job somewhere else because I already was permanent resident in the United States. I could work anywhere, I'm accepted. So I was accepted here in New Jersey in the company in Dorfell.
And what was that company?
That company is called INRAD, Internal Radiation, but short, it's INRAD.
Okay.
And that company still works. They stopped growing those crystals. They started buying crystals from China, from Japan, because it was cheaper than to produce with American labor. However, the salary from there went here. When I came here, went $15,000 more.
So that's good.
I was already American employee.
There you go.
Not employee from Bulgaria.
Plus you had experience
labor.
Already.
And I already had American experience.
Then that's, yeah, right.
So
that's
that was also appreciated. So I was here, but when the company decided to buy the crystals from abroad, which was cheaper, for them, China produced a lot of them. Japan, Singapore, they let me off. They just let me off. One day they said, Vasco, we don't want to grow those crystals anymore, so we're sorry. And they let me off on my birthday.
Happy birthday. There's the door.
Happy birthday. And on that birthday, I brought a big birthday cake there to feed everyone and some soft drink. And at the end, they gave me the order.
Wow. Leave.
Anyway, and then I found a job in Pennsylvania. They paid me six weeks only.
And that was
four weeks. The last 2 weeks they were not paid, and they paid me another 4 weeks there before I, when I left.
So now you go to Pennsylvania.
Then I went to Pennsylvania. How I got there?
Yeah.
That's a different story.
Okay.
While I was visiting professor up north New York in Potsdam, I was working together on my research program together with one PhD graduate student. His name is Greg. Greg Neugebauer. And at that time when I was laid off here, he was working in that company. I called him, hey, can you help me to find a job? He said, we are just now looking for a crystal grower. You just here. Can you come to Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania? I said, yeah, I will come. So they paid me the trip to there, back. I passed the interview, and they decided to hire me. So a month later, after I laid off, I started the job there. Absolutely new crystal, new type of crystal, new, absolutely new process I've never heard before.
Now does your family move with you to Pittsburgh?
No. No, we were trying to get there. I started very well. Then they gave me another $10,000 on my salary.
That'll help.
That'll help. And I already had like more than $60,000 salary. And I was a senior process engineer there, very high level. And I had 40 operators to supervise. So the job was not just to grow crystal, but also to develop new process, improve the old process, and new process for the new crystals, which we did. After being 1 year there, we decided that we could look for a house in Pennsylvania, in Pittsburgh. My wife came there, we would look around, the kids came there, look around. We couldn't find the house that we really would like to live in. Besides, both kids were already here. One was already a PhD graduate student, the other was in the college. So they decided to buy the house here.
In New Jersey?
In New Jersey, because we were in the apartment in Dumont. So several times I came here to also see some of the...
So you bought this house? The house we're in.
The other one was for rent before we bought this house.
Okay.
This is New Milford. We were living in an apartment there. Actually, my family was living in an apartment in Dumont.
Right, but this was your first house.
This one is my first house.
Okay.
And we finally bought this house. I was still in Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania. Now, I had no choice. Either I should stay there alone for more years, forever, or come here and look for another job. And I was lucky at that time. Very often I say I don't have good luck, but sometimes it does work. There was a conference there, and I think in Arizona it was there, in Tucson, Arizona. So I met two crystal growers from New Jersey here. Just by accident we were talking, they said, we were doing that. And I asked them, can you look that you may have me as a crystal grower here? And they came back here. I went back to Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania. One day they called me and said, okay, can you come here for the interview? Yes, we'll pay you a trip. Come over. And here they were growing crystal that I've never grown before, but I knew the process, I knew how to work, so I just need to have experience with this particular crystal. So they hired me, another $20,000 over the salary. So now I was on the level of American scientist, which I was there. They hired me as a senior scientist in the company to develop new process for the new crystals. And that crystal for me was new, but not for the United States. It's so I started there, working there, and I worked until they closed the company. For that time, every year I was here like 3.5 years. Every year they was raising my salary 5%. It was 6% in Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania, because the company was a Japanese company. It's called the bar. And Japanese have money, they paid a lot. So every year I got 6% there. Here I got everything. So I went almost close to $90,000 a year. But that company is called Litton Atron, was here, Litton Atron. And it was one branch of the big company located in Los Angeles. Actually, not exactly in Los Angeles, but somewhere California. And Northrop Grumman bought the whole company. And they said, we need airplanes, we don't need crystals. Closed the entire site here, which was 250 people, laid off in one day.
Wow.
In one day, 250 people. So that's how I finished my career on crystal growth. Yeah, I was looking for another job. I went to many interviews, maybe 15, 20 interviews all over the country. Colorado, Colorado Springs, North Carolina, South Carolina, up north in New Hampshire, anywhere. I was too old.
How old were you at this time?
I was 62 years old already, close to retirement. And every time I went there, they liked me, everything was good, but later on they hired somebody 35, 40 years old. Less experience, less paid. I always, here's what it happens here, which I never liked. I say, okay, I don't want my salary that was before. I don't want even to raise myself. Give me $15,000 instead of 100 or 90, and I'll say, we can't do that. Because one day you'll come back and say, okay, well, I had 90,000, now I want my 90. Mm. And they were looking for somebody who could do the close to the same job, but get less money.
So what is your next step then?
So one company here, they were selling crystals. So, my next step, while I was still there, because I was the one of the two people left in this little natron here before they sold the equipment to China, by the way. The equipment and closed everything because other people already were laid off and out. But everything was still in the company, to clean the company, to close the company, to sell the equipment we can could sell and also. So meanwhile, I was taking courses for real estate. While I was working like that, like 4 months I was there, before we closed the door, I got my license for real estate. Tried that job, didn't work for me very well, and I was not a good salesperson. do you think I'm a good salesperson?
I think you have a good way about you that, I think you can get along with people.
Yeah,
I think that's a big part of selling things is getting a connection with those people, especially in real estate.
Real estate is very difficult than in the store.
Yeah.
Because you have to find them.
Right. If you found them, if you were able to make contact with them,
then I could sell.
I think you'd be fine with that.
Yes. So that little company that I, after I was laid off, and I was already a real estate agent, the company was selling crystals. They buy crystals from somewhere and resell them somewhere else. So they needed somebody who understand of crystals, and they hired me there. But that was a little job. I agreed with the lower salary, and they gave me that lower salary. But the business reselling the crystals was not working very well. So they made enough money, maybe enough money, but not to pay that good salary for me. Meanwhile, the boss already, by himself, he learns a lot about that and decided to let me go. And I, again, was without job. So what happened? I laid home here doing nothing and got sick of every day. When you do nothing, you get sick.
Yes.
Not when you work very hard. When you do nothing, you got sick. Remember, people, when you do nothing, you get sick. So, and I went to talk to here and there in one store, Ace Hardware Store in Englewood. They invited me to work there as a salesperson, and I went there and started working. Because there is no shame work. You have no shame job. You can work anywhere if you like to work. If you don't like to work, any job is a shame. So I didn't look anymore for my profession. I was, by that time, I was 65 years already. I decided to take that job. And that's how I became a salesperson in the hardware store. Then later on, they closed that store, and I found that
they went out of business.
Yeah, out of the business. At that time, they didn't get. They were still in the business, but a year later, they closed the
company. They were getting ready to close.
They were getting ready. They were shrinking down, and first the who were not. There were two other people who were laid off before me, and I was one when they closed that department. Actually, that department was paint department. I was dealing with those paint. Everything was manual, not computerized, not programmed, not manually. There is a machine that shakes them. You have one there.
Yep.
I left there, and very soon, less than a month, I applied here in
River Edge.
In River Edge. So I'm already 9 years. By the way, today's what date? 26? 27?
26.
26. Tomorrow I make 11 years there.
That's a long time. So you're there a decade now.
Yeah, more than a decade. That's the second decade I'm already there for the same damn salary.
So the salary they hired you with never increased?
Never increased, never changed.
Is that the American way now?
That's the American way now. Now, how it was America? I remember there was another question. When I came 33 years ago in this country, that was incredible country. That was a great country. That was the great, and I would recognize by myself that was the great country. Service was high level service anywhere. No greedy. People were not that greedy like now. People were friends to everyone. I can't believe I go out from my apartment. I was renting an apartment. Go to school. I meet somebody. As soon as I meet their eyes, they smile all the way like that. Hi. 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 Not anymore. Even my colleague here came to work. Don't even say in the morning, Vasco, hi. Or not. Just go like I'm an empty spot.
So people are becoming like robots.
I don't know. People are not. People are not anymore that friendly. I don't know what happened to that people. But the major thing, service is way below that level that it was at that time. Today you can do anything. Oh, from the very first time, nothing. You have to call twice, the third time, fifth time, until somebody does it. What the reason is, I can guess, but I might be wrong. So I don't know what the reason is. Why this country became so...
Well, now you go back, you visit Bulgaria. How has that country changed from since
when
you left?
Now, what happened to Bulgaria is nothing good. So during the communism, yes, the economy was good, but we were not free to go anywhere. Actually, nobody stops you to go anywhere, but there were two problems. First problem, you don't have dollars, you don't have money. The salary in Bulgaria was 10 times less than my salary here. I can't buy a ticket even to go to the next country, Greece. The second reason, because Bulgaria was a communist country, no other country will accept that unless you get the visa. Now we have, now Bulgarian don't need visa almost nowhere. 180 countries Bulgarian go without the visa. But the economy is very low economy. People hardly make money there. If I go back to Bulgaria, I will never find my job. Not even close. I have to go to work in agriculture, where I actually came originally from. So, but I don't know. There are many reasons that happened, but one of the reasons when the economy in Bulgaria became a free market country, democratic country, and they call it free market country, people thought, okay, democracy is just to lay back, there is nothing, and the money will fall from the sky. And big part of Bulgarians actually didn't do anything. One part, the crooks and jerks, they stole all the money. They privatized garment industry for pennies. Even the company that called, I know one of the company that was probably several million dollars Bulgarian, they bought it for 10,000. These people now don't care about Bulgarians at all. So the Bulgarian economy is very, very low, and it's not, there is no light in the tunnel. You don't see what is ever gonna
but
be.
But it's cheap to live there, isn't it? Like to buy a house to.
Not anymore. The house is still a little cheaper.
Like if you want to buy a house in Bulgaria,
but if I
want
to buy a refrigerator, it's more expensive than here. But the salary there, the minimum salary is 300.
300 what?
Left Bulgarian, which is probably $150, the minimum salary. So, and the refrigerator like this, mine, yeah, is more expensive than here, in dollars.
But isn't, like, if you want to sell a house out in your village, well, how much are we talking about?
I'll tell you, I couldn't get more than 5,000 left, which is $3,000.
So for $3,000, you could buy a house?
Yeah, you can buy a house. Oh, even for 1,000 in my village, you'll buy that. But that's in the country, not in Sofia, not in the big cities. I'm talking about that. I have a house in Bulgaria, which I already spent 20,000 left, $15,000 already to renovate it, to improve it, all this. Mm. But I still cannot sell that house for more than 5,000 left, $3,000. So that's very different. Why I do that? Do I plan to go back to Bulgaria ever? Probably not, to go there, live forever, in this economical situation. Politics, I'm not interested in politics anymore at all. I have a house, probably I won't be able to live alone there. Why do I do that with the house? Because every time I go there, I relax. No stress, no nothing. Just go enjoy.
So do you think life is easier in Bulgaria or easier here in America? Right now.
For me?
For you.
For me, it's easier in Bulgaria. Why? Because I have pension in Bulgaria, I have pension here.
Right.
But for Bulgarian, whoever, who works still in the work level, it's much easier for them here. If they can find a job here, because it's very hard to find a job in Bulgaria.
So you would recommend a young Bulgarian to leave Bulgaria and live in the United States?
No.
No, you wouldn't?
No.
Okay.
I'll tell you, just because there's bad changing in the United States. One of the questions was, would you go somewhere else? If I knew what's going to happen in the United States for these 25 years, I would look for a job in Germany, in France, in England, and maybe in Spain.
But not America.
I would look for a job not in America. One of the reasons that what happened here. It's going, you probably feel that, but it's not that the other world is getting any better. No, but that's much closer to Bulgaria. From Germany to Bulgaria is one day drive, less than 24 hours. 18 hours I'm in Bulgaria, in the car. And 2 hours in the plane, I'm home. As I go to Washington, to my son, for more than 2 hours. So that was a very important reason, and it's still important reason I should look for a job there. but I was accepted here as a, I was invited to work. Like I said, I was not looking for a job. I was invited. I probably would never look for a job. I wouldn't want, but because I was scared. How can I go somewhere else to work? No, I live good in Bulgaria. But since I was invited, like I told you, my professor advised me to come here and try. And I did try. So far, so good. Still alive, still working, still have a good house, have $1 million house. I didn't say how I came here. When I came here, I have 2 cardboard suitcases and $20 bill in my pocket. That's what I had when I came in the United States 27 years ago. Now I have a house for $500,000. Yeah, I need
to pay. We were talking before this whole thing started about the concept of the American dream.
Time?
Being what you just said, let's break it down with you left Bulgaria. You had a mindset. You had, I'm sure, certain goals you thought were gonna accomplish, certain things you were gonna get by coming to America. Do you feel you got those things?
Most of them, yes. Most of them, yes. But I missed several times the train. So the first dream, reason, if when I came here was my dream, if it's called, to become a real good crystal grower. In Bulgaria, I was good, but Bulgaria didn't have and still doesn't have any finances to support crystal grow. If I change or I want to improve my technology, I don't have money. And Bulgaria doesn't have money to get. Here, anything I want, if I prove that this is a prospective one, I will get the money.
Right, but it didn't happen though.
Not entirely.
All right. Where would you have had gone to do that? Would you have gone to Japan? Would you have gone to China? Would you?
I was in China twice. I don't think I would like that. I don't mind China. They have a great crystal growth, great places to work. But I think that for my profession, it would be 2 places: France and Germany. That's really what they take.
Right, so
France and Germany. If France have a good crystal growth companies, they have them here too. And in France, they have them here.
So if you could turn the clocks back, or you could go back in time, some Terminator type situation, and you could talk to yourself, or you could redo things, would you have come to America? Like, that's the bottom line. Would you have come here?
No.
Or would you tell yourself, listen, don't do that, do this?
No.
What would your advice to yourself be?
I would advise, like I said, Germany became already one Germany. When I came first here, it was democratic Germany, communist Germany, and capitalist Germany. Now it's one Germany. I would go to Germany. Second choice would be England, and the third choice would be France. I actually could go to France if I didn't make a mistake when I applied there. I applied in France to grow laser crystals. From communist country, somebody to go to laser company in France, it's not gonna work, and they refused it. When I applied to United States, I didn't write anywhere laser crystals. And I didn't work on laser crystals here, that definite. I wanted to work on optical crystals, and I did work. That was my job here. So, to answer the question, that would be Germany, England, and France.
Now, would you have, if you had a choice between America and Bulgaria?
If there's 2 choices, that was America. I would come to America.
So you would take America over Bulgaria?
Economically, just economically, much better paid.
Okay.
I can't even compare. I told you, 10 times lower salary than I had it here.
So if you had stayed in Bulgaria right now, you'd be worse off.
Yes.
All right. So then that did work.
Yeah, it did work. It did work very well. Unfortunately, I didn't have a luck with that two companies that they closed the crystal growth. And that's not even America. Well, I think America make big mistakes selling companies outside. I myself sold that equipment from Litton-Atron to China. We should never do that. If the Chinese guy here who was interfering between us and China, he said, we wanted to buy that company and not to buy your equipment. We wanted to buy a company and leave your workers here. Our people decided to sell, to close the company and sell the equipment. Why did they do that? And so many companies that like that. By the way, that a company Barra in Pittsburgh also closed, went bankrupt. I mean, Japanese guy pulled off the plug. They tried to sell the company to some other people. That's closed also. A few years ago, 3 or 4 years ago, they closed that company. The other company, Inrad, stopped growing crystals. Why? Because they buy them from China, from Japan. So that's why it didn't work for me. Not because something else. They only first one fired me because he got angry that I was looking for another job. Actually, he closed the company too. That company.
So they all closed down in the end.
They all closed that company I work. Hopefully, that's not because of my presence. Hopefully. Because if it's that, that means that they closed Ace Hardware Store too.
Might happen.
Hopefully not. If I'm so dangerous person, but just by my presence to create closing the company, that's a bad thing. Even for me. Well, that's okay. It was good. That was bad, but more was good than bad.
All right. Well, that answers that answers all my questions. Did you have any things you wanted to add or
words of wisdom?
Words of wisdom about coming to America or staying in your own country or.
My wisdom for Bulgarians: don't go to the United States for work. Stay close to your country. Don't go. Not because they better paid here or not paid. They're equally paid in those three countries I just mentioned. It's not. But it's very far to go to your relatives. Unless you Bulgarians don't care about Bulgaria. So go anywhere in the world. America is one of that anywhere. So you can make good money here if you like to work. America needs workers, not lazy bastards. Okay, so that's why I would advise my all Bulgarian colleagues, if you want to live in America and stay in America, prepare yourself to work. To prove that, I'll give you one example. I have a friend in Bulgaria who is a professor, full professor there. He came here for 6 months, exchanging professor. He was 6 months here in Texas. When he was leaving, came to me to my visit. I said, why don't you stay here? Try to stay here. Oh, here people work a lot. I can't work that much. In Bulgaria, it's easier. So if you want to leave America, you prepare yourself to work.
Fair enough.
Nothing for free.
Vasko, thank you for your time. And everybody, thanks for watching. And I'll catch you later.
If you enjoyed the video, please take the time to like and subscribe.